This video highlights the NCBI's MedGen resource and how it integrates data from many sources important to medical practitioners and researchers needing pharmacogenetic information. We will explore these resources from the point of view of a practitioner who has diagnosed a fictitious patient with acute coronary syndrome, including evidence of coronary artery atherosclerosis. To treat it, an angioplasty is scheduled and the patient is told that after the procedure she will need to take clopidogrel for 3 to 6 months. The patient expresses concern that her father had been on the same medication but still died of a heart attack after months of taking it. So the practitioner decides to research the pharmacogenetics of clopidogrel response to see if a change in prescription might be indicated. The practitioner begins by searching NCBI's MedGen resource with the drug name and selecting clopidogrel response among the suggestions. Here we learn that Plavix, the brand name for clopidogrel bisulfate, and much easier to pronounce, requires the action of the CYP2C19 enzyme to form an active drug, and that specific genetic variants in the CYP2C19 gene influence the patient's response to Plavix. Within the record, the Medical Genetic Summaries section includes recommendations that poor metabolizers of Plavix, those with two dysfunctional copies of the CYP2C19 gene, receive an alternative drug, while intermediate metabolizers, those with one dysfunctional copy, either receive an alternative drug or an increased dose of Plavix. It is no surprise, then, that professional guidelines recommend genetic testing of CYP2C19 in this case, and provide guidance on drug therapy based on genotype. To find a genetic test to order, the practitioner goes to GTR, the Genetic Testing Registry, and narrows down the list of 19 tests by selecting CLIA-certified labs in the United States. She selects, just as an example, the 1-ohm WriteMed comprehensive test, reviews how to order the test, notes the CPT codes, and goes ahead and places an order. To better understand the upcoming test results, the practitioner clicks on View CYP2C19 Variations in ClinVar, where she finds that 4 of the ClinVar entries have been reviewed by an expert panel. When the genetic test results are back, they include one of those 4 alleles, the protein change given as P-TRP212-TER, a termination of the protein at tryptophan-212. The ClinVar record provides a lot of information for this allele, including other names, and you will see CYP2C19*3 and other resources later on, HGVS expressions, and farther down the page, allele frequencies. You could search ClinVar directly with that variant name and find the same record, and you can preview our new variation report layout. We'd love to have your feedback on that. So what are some options now that the genetic variant is known? First, the practitioner might want to verify the name of the variant given in the test report. They can do that by following the Medical Genetic Summaries link on the original MedGen page for clopidogrel response. In the Medical Genetic Summary entry, follow the link to Nomenclature of CYP2C19 Alleles. Here we see that the TRP212 termination allele has the common name CYP2C19*3, and we see a note that the normal or wild-type allele is designated *1. That will be useful to know in our next step, which is to explore therapeutic recommendations based on genotype. Scrolling back up this page, Table 2 is a great summary of the CPIC recommendations for various diplotypes and their correlation to phenotype and to therapeutic recommendation. Note that these recommendations are from authoritative sources outside of NCBI. Our patient's genotype and phenotype are here. This medical genetic summary page has more on recommendations. Back up in the table of contents is a section by the name Therapeutic Recommendations Based on Genotype. And we see here a warning issued by the FDA in 2017 regarding the diminished antiplatelet effect in patients with 2 loss-of-function alleles for the CYP2C19 gene. In addition, a link is provided to the NLM Daily Med site, which provides the complete FDA warning. So based on the patient's genetic profile for CYP2C19, that is a poor metabolizer of Plavix, the practitioner decides to change medications to prasugrel, which is not currently believed to be metabolized by CYP2C19, as this Medical Genetic Summaries article describes. If you have questions or feedback about MedGen, ClinVar, GTR, Medical Genetic Summaries, or any of our resources, we'd love to hear from you. Find the link to our Responsive Support Center at the bottom of virtually all NCBI web pages.